Hello everyone, welcome to Analog IAS Current Affairs Analysis for 26th of March 2020, and these are the couple of articles that we'll be dealing today. The first article for the day is taken from the Hindu and it is titled Dressing a Wounded Economy. This article is written by C. Rangarajan, the former chairman of the Economic Advisory Council to the Prime Minister of India. So recently, when he was speaking at length about how the central government and the central bank should respond to this unprecedented crisis presented by COVID-19, he said that the situation we are facing is very acute and very unusual. So the impact of virus is not necessarily known, but certainly given the situation, some drastic action is required. In this context, we have to see what kind of actions are required. And even if you look at it from the point of view of RBI, the central bank, whether the reduction of the policy rate or repo rate is the right kind of answer. Because we have seen across the world, due to this impact of COVID-19, many central banks are adjusting their repo rates or central Fed rates to ensure that economic slowdown does not actually impact the people. But right now, the entire world is under a lockdown. So this is a supply side shock. Now, how effective will be a monetary policy change that actually handles inflation in our country? That is the big question we have to answer now. Due to this unprecedented lockdown, many states are witnessing supply shocks, and the bottlenecks created due to this lockdown has only worsened the situation. Therefore, one has to look at the sectors that may be affected very badly. If we take a look at the equation for GDP growth, that is, in this situation, we have to note that even before this COVID crisis, our exports are doing pretty badly. Now, in a situation where the developed economies slow down and the demand for exports, which are already doing badly, falls down, it will severely impact our economy. Adding to this woes, we also have a consumption slowdown, and COVID-19 has really not helped our cause. Now, what is the situation after we survive this COVID-19 impact? What will be the domestic scenario and the external demand? Even with respect to essential goods like grains, pulses, etc., we would be witnessing a severe supply side constraint due to the lockdowns imposed. So even this factor should be ignored. As far as investments are concerned, this is not the right time to even think about investments, because the entire economies, global economies, are coping with this disaster of epic proportions. Now, government spending is the only savior. Now, it is here that most experts say that we have to forget FRBM targets for this year. Even NK Singh committee said that we can ignore FRBM targets in a crisis. So the government has done well indeed today by announcing that, rightly so, the government has announced a 1.7 lakh crores package for the poor people in our country who would not be able to afford a square meal because of this lockdown. So this is the only way at this moment that the government can really function. So the first priority of the government will be to contain this spread of COVID-19. Only then we can think about any economic revival, because across the world, we are in a moment of deep crisis. Unless and until we handle this, we cannot get out of this economic situation. Yes, the world is definitely staring into a recession after this COVID-19 eventually passes off. So that is the gist of this article. The next article for the day is taken from the Hindu. This article is written like a case study, so I would be treating it as a problem statement and the solution it offers. Now imagine a situation where the present situation, that is COVID-19 outbreak, happened in a particular district. Now what would be the scenario? You would be having legislators who would be knowing about the situation, both from the opposition party as well as the ruling party. You will be having media that would be putting pressure on the local bureaucracy. Now, if we have to deal with this situation, let us take a stock of the healthcare infrastructure and how would you deal with that particular situation? If you take a look at the case of beds, you don't have enough beds. If you take a look at the safety apparatus, in the present situation, we don't have even surgical masks as well. Forget the N95 variety for our healthcare workers. If you want to talk about medicines, we are probably short on all kinds of medicines that are required to treat even common flu. And if you want to talk about transport in a situation like lockdown, we have seen various instances where even dialysis patients who require continuous treatment are facing a lot of issues with transportation due to this lockdown. Now, the most important aspect is that of manpower. Do we have enough manpower? I highly doubt it. The reason being, we don't have enough number of doctors, neither do we have enough number of nurses per a set of population. It is in this situation that you expect the bureaucracy to function efficiently, and even the media would put a lot of pressure. And to top this up, there are sometimes even political pressures even during these times. To add to this situation, even in the normal situation, things are very difficult to pull off for the healthcare system. And in this present situation, we have even public not cooperating with the doctors. So this is the present scenario. In this gloomy state, can we find any positivity? Are there any solution? Yes, the article offers certain solutions. It is during these times of crisis that the district collector should take an early charge. When the district collector understands that the health systems are not up to the mark, the immediate task would be to mobilize officials and volunteers from all the sources available. So if the district collector is actually capable to mobilize forces from different departments and also volunteers, he can manage the minimum healthcare issues through these healthcare volunteers. But there are certain caveats here. If we take a look at the case studies conducted by the author of this article, the major issue is the political dependency in the postings of an officer in a particular district. So his ability and credibility are questioned, because most of the times he does not even understand his terrain. He is very new to the district and does not know what kind of resources he has. So in this context, it is important to give certain tenure to the district collector when he is handling a crisis. Secondly, during calamities, we have seen that many government officials have resorted to corruption. This is probably the lowest point in governance, but that is a matter of fact. Thirdly, when we look at the time, if a particular disease like COVID-19 persists for a longer period of time, there is very little that the district collector can do. So the premise of this article is this. We have had a lot of discussions regarding the role of district collector in a crisis like this. Everybody who are sociologists and other people blame the district collectors for not being able to manage this crisis effectively. Yes, that is definitely a part of the problem, but the larger problem we have to look at is the health system crisis. We don't even have proper healthcare infrastructure. Now, when the mobility of this volunteers is restricted severely in these times of crisis, how would you expect a district collector to support the healthcare infrastructure in a particular district? The real heroes during these times would be the healthcare workers, who are the front line of defense. So instead of working on the basics, that is building the healthcare infrastructure, too much criticism about the district bureaucracy is not warranted according to the author. So the immediate focus of almost all the governments across the world should be local governance, and health and education should be given immediate importance. If we probably had a strong local government as well, we would have easily handled this situation in a better way. That is the gist of this article.